Okay, so I'm gonna change the oil in this thing. The Triumph Daytona 595. I've just bought it. I don't know what the oil's like. I don't know if these clips are standard or not. Have you seen them? Oh, that's kind of seized a little bit. You need a bit of WD-40. Yeah, they look like they need WD-40, don't they? I've only got a wee bit. A second. So I've just bought this bike and I have no idea when the oil was last changed, so I'm just gonna change it. I'll leave that. I need a little Allen bolt for there. If they're gonna do it, they would say. Or if they'd done it, they would have said, wouldn't they? Because that's a decent selling point. Is there any tools on that paintwork? That one's come out. Let's see what I can use. And then saw the series of that. It's turning okay. I'll get most of them out and I'm gonna have a look on the other side. I just don't want to damage the paintwork. I can help it. So can I give it a wee second just to do its thing. I might block this bike up a tiny bit. Too much. Just lift it up a little bit. Gotta start the engine up as well, get the engine warm, take an oil out. So I'm just wiggling it backwards and forwards. Goodness knows when this was last off. Probably don't need to do this, but I'm going to be converting the bike anyway. Patient here. That's it. So I'm not just turning. No, the nut's not turning. The screw is just gently with it. So it's difficult to get in there. Even getting any penetrating oil in there is quite hard. I've sprayed all these. That's it. I'll leave that for a few seconds. Let's see if I can get these ones off. Cable tie again. Get the cable tie again. So just get the cable tie, some in plastic. So it doesn't damage the paintwork. Oh man. Yeah, they're all rusty, you see. All these little clips. Oh, it's just coming away. That was loose anyway. Good idea, that cable tie. Gentlest way to do it, isn't it? Wow, that was really tight. Working on your knees again. That's it. Pop that through there. Push it through a bit further if I can. That's it. Got a good purchase on it. Wow. Very hard. It's so corroded. To leave it for a few seconds. It's coming now. I have to sit these in a wee bath of, what do we call it, WD-40. Wow, really corroded. Try that way. Wow, throwing the fingers. Okay, that's got it. Has he never heard copper slip? So I'm going to do it with a hand now. There we go. I'll oil them up. Just get these wee clips out now. This should come up alright. That's it. Get this one out. Yeah, they're a wee bit rusty, but I put them in a little bath of thingamy. You know thingamy. WD-40. That's it. Any more? Anything else? That's it. I'm just going to get a little container, just a cap, full out with WD-40 and put all these in it. All these nuts and bolts, and just let them sit in the WD-40. Back in a minute. So that's them sitting in WD-40. And they'll sit there quite happily. And they'll be a lot better, they'll be a lot cleaner. And I'll just get them covered. And it doesn't damage the rubber then. Perfect. Right, where was I? Okay. Changing the oil. Start the bike up, get it warm. To look at the Triumph owner's handbook. Now, have you just seen this? I don't know if you can see this. But that little screw, that quick release screw, has been digging into the crankcase. Whoa! So that's not going back in. Something else will have to go back in there. That's not good. Hopefully, it's a thick case that it's not leaking oil, but goodness me. I want to see how much. See how much oil this thing takes. Okay, oil, engine oil capacity. 4 litres. I bought 4 litres. Fabulous. That's the whole can. See that? 4 litres there. 4 litres. Including fill to wet fill. Fabulous. We found it eventually. Okay. Back up. Let's join the terminal. What size and bolt that is. Okay. What do you reckon, a 12? I'll bring a 14 just in case. I have a 12, 13 and a 14. One of them lot. I'm missing keys in my pocket. Right. Let's get the front plug bolt off. Right. of, what size do you reckon it is? About 13 there. I think it's a 13. It's a 13. Now which way is loosened? Ah, that way is loosened. Okay, and the ignition key is out, you stout. Where's the, well, the filler's there. The thing of the oil, what's it? Oil filter. Just spin it so you can see it. Hopefully that'll take 4 litres, that cat trailer thing. It doesn't, it's all over the, it's all over the drive. I'll just clean that. I want to have a look for a wee bit of swarf, see if there's any on it. So one cloth for the old oil. That oil doesn't actually look too bad. Let's check the stringiness of it. Nah, it's not stringy, it's old. I'll just show you. A bit of oil on my fingers. There's a bit of oil. If it, see, it's just breaking, there's no pull on it. It should just have a, there's a wee bit of a pull on it. It might be new oil. There's a tiny bit of a pull on it. That might be fresh oil. There's a wee bit of a pull. Oh, it's getting changed now. I'm not putting it back in. I'll take the cap off as well. Just loosen the cap. So what I'll do first is I'll clean around the cap. You always have to make sure there's no stones or anything. Just because we collect in there. There's nothing in there, so that's okay. I'll give it one quickly. You always have to watch that. I don't want any of these stones in there, in your engine. So I'll always give it a little wipe and a little blow, get all the debris out of the way. I'll open this up anyway. I'll just open it and leave it loose. There we go. Let's get the filter out. I've got a little filter tool. And then once you get the filter out, inspect. Inspect something. Inspect the, that photo, it's all gonna fit, yeah, it should fit. Which way was loosened? It's different when you're upside down. It should just come loose, it shouldn't be for animal tight, like. Just an awkward, it's awkward up there. Get your hand on it. It's coming now though. That's it. Should get it on my hand now. There we go. It's quite a good idea that to have it underneath, because it makes sure you get all the oil out. There's quite a lot of oil in there. Where's my rag? I guess where my rag is. Over the other side. Oh, a long thread. Oh, oil on the drive time. Get some oil on the drive. Yeah. Well, it's a Triumph filter, so it hasn't just been changed, is it? That's the original filter. The filter I bought is not Triumph. I'm just going to inspect the sump plug a minute. Let's have a look at the sump plug. see if there's any spark from it. I don't think there's any spark on it. That's fine. Nice and clean. I just put it back in. Just put it back in like that. Fine. Okay, I'll let that drip by my cup of coffee. Get back to you soon. I've got my coffee, so I'm happy. I just wanted to show you the difference in the brake and oil. This is brand new engine oil. Let's see if there's any difference in the brake. Let's have a look. It's braking a lot. Yeah, it's taking longer to brake. So it's a lot more elastic oil. The other stuff wasn't too bad, because sometimes if it's really old oil, it doesn't break at all. It's almost like water. You can see I can kind of have a stalactite and a stalagmite there. Have you seen that? You can tell that's good oil. So the oil in there wasn't too bad actually. It needed changing. It felt as the original Triumph, so. Whether he used an original Triumph filter, that's maybe what he's done. Where's my cloth? Well, I'll put this cap back on. That's the course of wisdom, to put the cap on an open bottle. Let's get my cloth. This stuff here, super. This was £30 and this was £7.50 from a local. I like to support local shops. That's good. I'll fill it up first before I put it on the bike. And we'll prepare that now. I'm going to use the cardboard box to sit it on and keep it nice and neat. It's going to end up being an unfair bike. Fill that with a bit of oil. Got a bit of oil from the last time. Had an oil change exactly the same oil. I just hope there's just no debris in it. Doesn't look like there is. I'm thinking I better not use it. I'll use it for oil and stuff, because there might something that it was left unopened this way. Nothing on the top of it. I don't want to use that. Maybe use a wee bit for the ring. That'll be okay. Just for this little ring. You see, you need to put a bit of oil on that. You all know that anyway. Just a wee bit of oil on there. Nice new oil. I've seen folks use old oil. Why? You know, you gotta use new oil every time. And just fill this up, not right to the top. Let it gurgle a little bit. Like, fill it up and leave it to sink down. So it's taken the sun down quite a bit. That was full. It's still sinking. See? Wow. Still sinking. Filling up all the little cavities and stuff. And the little channels. Leave that for a minute. Alright, get some oil on it, in it. Just gently. It's hard when you've got a big new container. I don't want to fill it too much, there we go, that'll do. Just to the bottom of the threads. Yeah, that'll be fine. I'm gonna get the cap back on it. I don't want to spill that. Yeah, that's fine. It's not completely full, but it'll be fine. That's it. I'll be fine at that. There's oil in there anyway. I'm just going to put the whole lot in the bike. Start it up. And then I've got some more that I can top up with if I need to. Where are we? What is that? when I look at it. I'll have my cup of coffee and I'll wait till it's looks different. Definitely not as warm as yesterday. Now where's the drain plug? I just cleaned the face of that drain plug. Get all the old rubbish off it. Make sure there's nothing that's gonna impede the seal. Doesn't have to be insanely tight, just has to be nipped up. Looks like a little bit more. That'll do it. Now I'll just test that. Just nip it up, it ain't gonna come out. And what I'll do is I'll get this away completely. I can't really see underneath there to see what that's like underneath there, but just check the face and my finger. Okay, get this filter up in there, nice and gentle. This is where it paid to have a bench. So which way is clockwise? Am I on the thread? Yeah, we're on the thread now. Just wind it up. I like to do these hand tight, but I'm not going to be able to. I just nip them up. Don't have to be tight at all. Is that going to go on that? Is that going to go on there? That tool's the wrong size for that one. That kiddie. I'll have to get a tool for that filter. Surprised at that. See if I can do it up hand tight. All I ever do them up with anyway is hand tight. And if it leaks, I just tighten it up some more. Get the cloth involved. Anyway, cloth in your way. A bit difficult. So you can't get a proper grip on it. I do have another tool, but it's a different kind of tool. It's like a strap. Wow. It's annoying that doesn't go in there. It's frustrating that. I have to get another one of them tools. I bought that years ago for a CBR 600. I just assumed it would fit. Just try to get it really as tight as you can, hand tight. That's the way you to do it, and that's the correct torque. I just have to do it at that. There's a 13. Yep. Check that again. Yeah, that's perfect. Okay, let's get some oil in there. Let's see if it leaks. All there, and just have to keep the cloth handy. Right,
actually quite straightforward because it's just the whole 4 meters as well. Excuse the sniffing. Oh, where's that coffee of mine? Have a coffee. Right. Oh, excuse me, something plug off. I've got the cloth handy, I have. Right. Check the sump plug. I'll give that a wee wipe actually. Make sure there's nothing, no foreign bodies in it. That's fine, put that there. The cloth handy, or those bits of stuff on the cloth. And what I do, I fill up the jug slowly, half full. That'll do it. Takes a while, but don't mind. It ain't a race. A wipe so I don't get oil everywhere. Keep the cloth handy and then just pour it in. And I'll come back when I've filled it up. So I'm halfway. I've just realised I've got this here, which is another form of tool. I can get to it from this side, but I'll put this oil in and try to tighten that up. Get to the off foot from this side. For a second, I just nip that up. Fold it up so you can see it. That's it there. You just pop that on there, if I can, and then just one wee nip on it. Off a little bit. That's it. If I can tighten that up, I don't need to be on it a fair lot. It does need nipped up a little bit. Just so I can give it a wee half turn, you know. That's it. That's it. I can just keep that there and just check it, see if it drips. Carry on putting oil in this thing shortly. So that's it. This is the last of the 4 litres just about to go in. But I want to just lift the bike up and quickly check the level where we're at. That needs a little bit more. Just check I'm on the side stand properly. Yeah, I'm on the side stand properly. That's why I always kind of strap the front brake up. But I reckon I'll take all this, but I'll put half of this in and then start the engine. And I always keep the old oil can to put the old oil in. And I take the old oil down to the dump, which you can just pour into a big canister. And don't throw it in the bin. I won't put all this in, but I'll put most of it in. But it did say 4 litres, but there will be some oil in there still. I just check that level, and also what I do, I have a really old, awful rough cloth, and I can just wipe up any drips on the floor. I don't want to use a nice cloth to do this. I get all bits of sand and stuff in it. Okay, so let's bring this round. Okay, I put the filler cap on. I just want to just check the level. Okay. I cleaned out for the cup before. I'm not going to screw it right down, but and get it in. There we go. That's it. I'll just nip it up. There we go. That'll do. Give that a wipe. I've got a tiny bit of oil left, but I've got some more as well. Bring this over to here, and we can check the level together. You'll probably see it better than me. Oh dear. try and get the bike kind of upright. Hard to judge it. And that's it without being started, so it's full up even without being started. You can see that, can't you? See? That's kind of where it's supposed to be. But once I get it started, it'll be different. I'm just going to start it up. Make sure one side's done right. It's a handy wee tool that. Just quite a tight space to get into there with that. You can get it from the side a little bit. I just for a while. You get a fiver out somewhere. No idea where. Nice little tool. Let's check the level. See where we are. So that's it. On the level, that's absolutely spot on, that is. Well, I'll let it get right down. Check that, it's on the stand probably. And give it, the trick is to give it a few minutes to dribble right down, and you get a proper accurate level then. There is a wee bit of oil left, but not all of it would have drained out of the engine. There will still be some of the old oil in there. Well, that's gone. 30 quid straight on the bike. It's worse. You can pay a lot more than that, can't you? Yeah, still no drips. It's cheddar level. I'll just rock it. So that. Yeah, that's fine. It always changes when you're on. It's right at the top. Where it should be. It's right at the top of the sight glass. So I'm rocking. That's coming towards me now. That's on the balance point there. So it's right at the very top. Just make sure that's all the sides down when I've got it. A very dear bike to drop even at a standstill. That'll be fine. So that's changing the oil. All I've got to do is button it back up, not put the bolt back in here. That's just crazy, isn't it? Bored a big hole in there. In the crankcase. Goodness. This is how I dispose of the old engine. I've got one of these things, a fantastic thing. In the old tub. Not dispose of it, but get it ready for a proper disposal. I put it in a little washing tub. And just pour it in. So I put it in the little basin, the washing basin, my wife's old washing basin. Interesting to see how much came out of the bike. This is
always get these old cloths. That's not the old cloth we're going to. There's not that much to wipe up. See how much is taken. How much has come out of it? Just over 3 litres come out of the bike. Weird. 4 litres went in. So it almost been low. Should really been checked at the shop. Anyway, take that out. It's only used for that purpose. It isn't used for any other purpose. And then just put that to one side for the take down the dump. I'll get that old cloth. Anyway, that's how I do it. Also, just while we're here, I'm going to leave that off for now until I've absolutely got the level correct, because it's easier to see the level. It's quite hard to see it with this on. So I'm leaving that off for now until I'm absolutely sure it's perfect. So here's a little puzzle for you. Ow! If you've got one of these single sided swinging arms and no centre stand, look, must not stand in situ, nothing to be seen in the centre stand. How do you oil the chain? Adjusting the chain of single sided swinging arm is simple. One bolt, adjust the cam, and that's it. You don't even need to put it up on a centre stand, it just does it. You just need a pal to, you sit on the bike, you need 10mm of play, that's it. You sit on the bike, he checks you've got 10mm in the middle of the chain, job done. How? Do you oil it though? You just move it a little bit, oil a bit of the chain, move it, oil a bit of the chain, you can do it that way. I've got a paddock stand coming today, but I haven't had it for a week. I had this bike a week without a paddock stand, so I made this little thing. I'll just show you. I made this. Yeah, baby. I got a wooden pole. We'll just lift the bike up, get out of the way of the camera, lift the bike up, and I put on the pole, and I grease the pole, and I can just get a little bit of oil on the chain. Perfect. Just one revolution. You're not supposed to be on the outside, but anyway. But we've got on the outside. Just one revolution. Just get around the chain. Try and get a wee bit on the inside. Not getting over the back tire. That's it. And let's lift the bike up again. Gently. Oh. That's it. One wee tool. Bike lifting tool. Yeah, block of wood. Things you do. Anyway, that's it done. It's done the job for now. Yeah, it'd probably be easier to use in the paddock stand. But we'll see. If this is just a quick, if I need to quickly oil the chain, just use that. Fantastic.